Greetings everyone, this will be a short video to explain how to use CUDA 11.6 version after the latest Automatic1111 update to be able to do training correctly by using either DreamBoot or Textual Inversion. Moreover, I will show how to use dev branch of DreamBoot extension to be able to use LoRA if you have 8GB VRAM having GPU. If you are interested in learning more, I have very detailed several videos. So this is the playlist of my stable diffusion related videos on my channel. If you are interested in to learn more information, I suggest you to watch with this order: first, zero to hero stable diffusion, then how to do stable diffusion textual inversion, then how to inject your trained subject, then DreamBoot got buffered 22 January update. This will teach you a lot of information related to stable diffusion, and finally you can watch my older how to do stable diffusion LoRA training video, but this is not very up to date at the moment, and hopefully I will make much more updated one. So Automatic1111 recently updated its torque version and xformers version to latest ones or the more updated ones. You see the torque version is now 1.13 and CUDA version is 11.7. However, this is currently not very well supported by DreamBoot or Textual Inversion training. How do I know? There are several issues topics on the GitHub of Automatic1111, and you see don't use torque 13, it is breaking the functionality, or CUDA use CUDA 11.6. So in this video I will show you how you can revert back to older version of CUDA after you have upgraded. By the way, it will ask you to upgrade your torque version with this command line argument. If you have already updated, watch this video to learn how to downgrade, or if you are doing a fresh installation, watch this video to learn how to do downgrade. So for downgrading our torque and CUDA version, we are entering our installation folder, as you can see stable diffusion web UI master, and enter inside the VNV folder, and inside here enter the scripts folder. Let me show you with zooming in. This is the folder where you need to enter first the installation folder, inside that VNV folder, and inside that scripts folder. Then in here type cmd. It will open cmd window with that path, as you can see right now. Then with the following order, we are going to execute each one of these commands inside here. I will put all of these commands into the description of the video, so don't worry about that. I am just copying and pasting them like this and hitting enter one by one. It will ask you to proceed and click and hit I keyword and hit enter. By the way, I got error because both of my CMD windows for running stable diffusion is open. Make sure that you have closed them first. Once you close your CMD windows, you will see that successfully uninstalled torchvision. Then execute the next command like this, and it's executed. Then execute the next one like this. Okay, it is asking, and hit I keyword and hit enter. Then we are going to execute this command. This will take some time because it will download the CUDA version. If you get a warning like this, it is just fine, just ignore it. Okay, in the end you will get a message like this. Ignore this error message and focus on this message. You see successfully installed torque 1.13 and CUDA 11.6. then the next command is the xformers installation. Just copy and paste it in here and hit enter. Okay, let me copy paste again. Okay, now it is installing that one as well. Okay, now we are all ready. We can now start our application as usual. I'm just starting with xformers, and I am using the latest commit of the Automatic1111. Let me show you which one it is. It is 12 minutes ago updated, and its hash is this. I will put this into the description of the video as well. Okay, now we have started like this with the newest installation, and let's go to the extensions and click available, load from, and in here let's install the DreamBoot extension like this. You see while installing, I am seeing now the checking DreamBoot requirements, and it is showing me the installed things. Torque version is 1.13, and CUDA is 11.6, and torchvision is this one. So currently we are on the correct. And after installation is completed, we need to restart CMD window. But before starting again, now I will show you how to move to the developer branch of the DreamBooth extension. From here, go to the installer, click here. It will open the GitHub repository of the extension. And in here, currently you are seeing the main branch. By default, it is installing the main branch. However, there is also development branch, and which is the most up-to-date branch. Actually, I think he just merged it with the main. But I will still show you the developer branch, because in future you may need it. Yes, he just updated while I started the video. So how we are going to load into the development branch? We are going to enter our extensions folder. By the way, to do a fresh installation, just delete this folder and you can then fresh install your extension and enter inside here. And in here we are running CMD. By the way, for Git commands to work, you need to have installed Git bash or any Git repository handler. For example, if you type Git bash, you can see its link in here, and you can download it and install it. Then the Git commands will work. And then we will pull the development branch, Git pull origin dev. It will pull the development branch for me. It says it's already up to date. Then you need to do Git checkout dev. Okay, now we are already in the development branch. This is how you check out. If you encounter error, you can just do Git stash, and it will stash the local changes. Then you will be able to check out the development branch. Now I will check out the main again, so we can use the main. And after doing that, you see it is telling me switch it to branch main. I will just restart CMD window. Which one? We still didn't start the CMD yet. Okay, sorry about that. Let's just click the start. And now I will show you how to do LoRA training and generate ckpt from save with checkpoint. Okay, we are finally started and correct torchvision and xformers. Currently we will use this CUDA version. However, I am pretty sure that the developer will fix the problem with CUDA 11.7 in future. Then you won't be need to downgrade your CUDA version. Let's refresh our automatic 11.11 web UI. Go to the DreamBooth tab. And now for LoRA to appear, first we need to pick LoRA, and now LoRA dropdowns will appear. Of course, we will first generate a LoRA model as test one, and you will see a new experimental thing, unfreeze model. Currently, I am working on to figure out the best settings to do LoRA training. However, it is taking time. I am making this video to show you the latest changes, and when I get more information to train a better LoRA model, hopefully I will make another video. So I will use just the default settings for now and just create model. However, you can still play with unfreeze model option. You see it says that unfreezes model layers and allows for potentially better training, but makes increased VRAM usage more likely. Okay, once the model is generated, you will see this model is selected here, and we still started training, therefore it is not appearing here. Then in here I am I think they fixed it, this generate classification images using text image. Let's also try that. Let's say 500 epochs, zero. Let's save model preview and model saving weights every 5 epochs. And you see these are the default learning rates. Actually, these are not very optimal right now. When I figure out the optimal ones, hopefully I will make another video. Let's type our usual sanity prompt, photo of OHWX man by Tonlar Hanuka. If you watch my more detailed videos, you will learn more about why we are doing sanity sample prompt and other settings. Okay, in here I am selecting now FP16 because FP16 have better precision than BF16. Actually, I was knowing incorrectly in my previous videos, so FP16 is supposed to have better precision and better performance. If you check this cache latency, it will use more VRAM. So if you have 8 GB of VRAM GPU, then you may not want to check this, but I suggest you to first try it. If you get out of memory error, then uncheck this. And we are going to train unit. I think without this, it is using about 7 GB of VRAM, so you can still train unit with this. And there is also new another experimental thing, which is freeze clip normalization layers. Keep the normalization layers of clip frozen during training. Advanced usage may increase model performance and editability. However, again, this is very experimental and I am yet to figure out the best working settings. I have been working on them for over 2 days and still I am not figuring out the best settings. And as usual, let's set up our training directory and other things. So I am going to use this training dataset. This is 9 images. They are all different backgrounds and different clothes. Okay. Classification, let's say example. Okay. Instance token and FileWords. So in my previous video, I explained how to use FileWords. I am not going to repeat it here. Let's just say OHWX man and photo of man. And photo of OHWX man. Okay, these are the classical things. And let's say 100 images per instance image. Okay, and in saving, you can generate a ckpt when training completes, but 500 epochs is very likely to overtrain. Actually, it is becoming too fast overtrained with default settings. LoRA rank, this is also another new thing. And as you increase LoRA rank, it is supposed to hold more data, but I tested that, and when I increased it to maximum, the results were much worse than the default 4. So still I am yet to figure out the best settings, and hopefully when I figure out, I will make another video. Generate LoRA weights when saving during training. With this way, it will generate the checkpoints for us, then later we will be able to pick the checkpoint and generate a ckpt from that. Okay, click save settings and click train. Let's see if it will generate the classification images. We pick it well previously. Okay, in here it is showing correctly the number of steps, so I am thinking that it will generate now. Yes, it generated. Why there is text to image tab, so you can customize the image generation from here. Alternatively, you can batch generate from here and give the folder path. Now I will show you my previous training results because I just did a training before starting this video. Okay, this is from my previous training with LoRA with the same settings as I just shown. And you see I lost stylizing even after the 187 steps, and when you divide it by 9, it was just over 20 epochs. And as you see, the results are not very good, and it takes a lot of tries to get your results stylizing. I have used this specific checkpoint 1356 to generate ckpt and generate images from that. So how do we generate ckpt? Go to the DreamBooth tab and in here select the model. Okay, then make sure that you have selected use LoRA, and then you will see the generated ckpt points, and in here select the ckpt point that you want to generate a ckpt. Select the LoRA model checkpoint, then make sure that you click it first, load settings, then click save settings. Otherwise it is not working. Actually, the last time I tried, it was not working. Once you see config save it, click generate ckpt, and in here you will see the messages. Okay, you see it has loaded first test one 1356 checkpoint. However, it generated a ckpt file name with the latest step of the training. This is incorrect. I have reported this to the developer and I am hoping that it will get fixed soon. After a ckpt is generated, you can just click refresh and you can now start using your LoRA trained model. And now let me show you the results I have got from my previous tries. I have used these as command prompt. This is the positive prompt and this is the negative prompt. And now let me show you the outputs. So you see the outputs are all my face, the subject I teach, but the stylizing is very poor and the quality is also poor. I think it is already pretty overtrained, and so we need better settings. It certainly learns your subject, your face. However, it loses its ability to stylize your face as in the DreamBooth, because the last video I made for DreamBooth was extremely successful, which you can watch in this video actually. So the LoRA is currently very inferior than the DreamBooth with the default settings, but with these new experimental settings, I am hoping that it will become much better once we figure out the optimal settings. Still, you can stylize it, but it is much harder than DreamBooth. You need to generate a lot of images, and you need to test different CFG and perhaps checkpoints. I hope you have enjoyed it. Please subscribe, like, comment, share, and hopefully I will let you know the news. If you also support us on Patreon, I would appreciate it very much. Currently we have 12 patrons, and I appreciate them very much for supporting us. They are making me to continue produce more quality content. You can also join our Discord channel from here, and I will also put the Discord channel link into the description. Hopefully see you in another video.